It's an old familiar saying that goes, the apple does not roll far from the tree. The apple does not roll far from the tree. And it is often used in reference to a child being similar to a parent. A child normally has similar characteristics or similar qualities to his or her parents. And we see that playing out in today's gospel reading. But before we get to that, we need to ask ourselves, what was the context or circumstances leading up to today's reading? In the first 15 verses of this chapter, Jesus healed a man who was ill for 38 years. The healing took place on the Sabbath, and as we see in verse 16, some of the Jewish leaders didn't like what was happening. Healing people on the Sabbath was a no-no. And furthermore, Jesus' response in today's reading was a result of what was said in verses 17 and 18. But Jesus answered them, "My Father is still working, and I also am working." For this reason, the Jews were seeking all the more to kill him, because he was not only breaking the Sabbath, but was also calling God his own Father, thereby making himself equal to God. So in answering their concern, Jesus says, "I am equal with God. My Father is always working, and so am I working as well." Now, he will later say in John chapter 10 and verse 30, "I and the Father are one. The Father is in me, and he is in the Father." And he says that in verse 38. Healing persons on the Sabbath would have made the Pharisees and religious authorities very angry. They would have been wondering, who does he think he is? And if that was not bad enough, Jesus is claiming to be equal to the Father was tantamount to blasphemy. In the eyes of the religious authorities, Jesus was committing blasphemy and saying that he is God, a claim that was punishable by death. And the Jewish authorities were not only persecuting him for doing works on the Sabbath, but they were planning on killing him because he was even calling God his own Father, making himself equal to God. Nevertheless, Jesus enlightens the religious leaders with three things. The relationship of the Son to the Father. The Son is the one who judges. And the Son is the one who gives eternal life. And first, Jesus was equating himself to being equal with the Father. "Very truly, I tell you, the Son can do nothing on his own, but only what he does, the Father, only what he sees the Father doing. For whatever the Father does, the Son does likewise." And John, in his Gospel, reveals to us that there is a relationship between Jesus and his Father. Jesus is God in the flesh. And Jesus speaks of God as his Father, making himself equal to him. And here we see the dynamics of the Trinity at work. And John's Gospel tells us that they are both equal in their divine and human natures. Remember, John opened his Gospel with these words, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one came into being." And so just as the Father is working to bring about salvation, to bring about redemption to everyone, to reconcile those who are lost and to bring them back to him, Jesus is expected to do the same. He is expected to follow his Father's lead, and the work they are doing is so important and astonishing that Jesus tells us there will even be greater work than what you are already seeing. So Jesus equated himself to be equal with the Father. Second, Jesus is seen as the one who will judge. "The Father judges no one," Jesus says, but has given all judgment to the Son, so that all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. And not only will the Father have the Son carry out his mission of love and mercy and compassion, he would also have him carry out his mission of judgment. The Father has given all judgment to the Son. And even Paul speaks about this in Acts chapter 17. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed the day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed. And of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. And this man of whom Paul speaks, that God has appointed and whom he has raised from the dead, is Jesus himself. But the ironic thing is that the religious leaders who were judging and condemning Jesus did not realize that the one who God had appointed to judge humanity, including them, is the same one that they are judging and condemning. And third, the one who will judge is the same one who gives life. And although those who oppose Jesus will condemn him, they do not realize that without him, they too will be condemned. For only the Son can give them life. And in the same way, only the Son can give us life, and that is eternal life. And Jesus speaks of eternal life being available today, for the hour is coming and now is here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. We need to believe that the Son is both judge, and his judgment is fair and just, and he also gives life. And the reason why the Father chooses Jesus to do these things is so that all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. And so, my friends, we are called to honor Jesus just as we honor the Father. We are called to honor Jesus because he is the Son of God and the Son of Man. We are called to honor Jesus because he is God. We are called to honor Jesus because he has been given the task to be our judge and the one who gives us life. We are called to honor Jesus because he and the Father are one. Therefore, we need to believe Jesus in what he did through his miracles and healings and showing love and compassion for people, in what he said through his words and his teachings, and in what he promised, particularly that he's coming again. It means that we need to truly follow him, surrender to him, and obey him. For in doing so, we have the hope of not coming under judgment. We have the hope of passing from death to life. We have the hope of eternal life. Amen.